I'm going to start off here now talking about the metabolic testing. What tests are we going to run and what does it mean to you and your child? First of all, with all kids that have dyslexia, I'm going to run sensitivity allergy testing to determine if your child has a sensitivity or an allergy to gluten, which is wheat, rye, barley, or an allergy to milk, eggs, soy, and yeast. If they have allergies to any of these food groups, it could be making your child's dyslexia worse as it increases inflammation in their brain and throughout their body. Some of the symptoms of these IgG allergies or food responses are chronic pain and fatigue, frequent indigestion. They may feel bloated after eating. They have frequent loose bowel movements followed by constipation. You may find that they get mouth ulcers and sores on the edges of their mouth. And many times you'll find that they have a higher tendency to vomit. The only way to really find out if your child is suffering from one of these IgG food allergies is to run the test, and that's what we do. We also run complete blood panels. By using specific blood tests such as a thyroid panel, a complete metabolic panel, a lipid panel, a CBC with differential, we're able to assess your child's thyroid, your child's adrenal glands, the liver, the kidneys, the red and white blood cells, and even their gut function. Okay, all of these areas can be affected and are affected with chronic health conditions, chronic neurologic conditions like dyslexia. By addressing any of these problems with your child's thyroid, the adrenal glands, and the blood chemistry, or even their gut function, we're going to actually be able to help them heal faster. Now, the complete metabolic panel also allows us to check your child's blood glucose levels. And this is very important since glucose and oxygen are needed by the brain to function properly. We also run what's called an adrenal stress index. This actually tests the adrenal glands. It's a salivary test, which is much like DNA testing. The adrenal glands sit right above the kidneys, and they are your child's stress organs, meaning that they're going to react to stress. So if your child's body has been or is currently under stress, and if they're suffering a neurologic disorder, it certainly is, this test is a must. If your child deals with insomnia or has problems, difficulty sleeping at night, and energy levels throughout the day, this test is a must. We also run immune panels, which is extremely important. Most of our dyslexic patients, we find that they have an underlying autoimmune condition. This is why the immune panels are so important to find this and to appropriately manage it. There are two parts to the immune system. You have your Th1 side and your Th2 side. Interleukin-2 and TNF-alpha are your Th1 cells. The Th1 cells are your T cells. The T cells are the army that attacks and cleans up afterwards. They include your helper T cells, your suppressor T cells, and your macrophages. The interleukin-4 and the interleukin-10 are your Th2 system. Your Th2 system is really your B cells. Your B cells are what make antibodies. They are the post-it notes that tell the T cells what to attack. So if you have a B cell dominance, you're a Th2 dominant individual. To properly evaluate the immune system, we have to run the T and B lymphocyte panel, the natural killer cell panel. We're going to check your interleukin-2, TNF-alpha, interleukin-4, interleukin-10 levels. We want to determine if your child has an active antigen or an immune dysregulation problem. Active antigens, some examples are parasites, bacteria, viruses, foods that you're allergic to, chemicals, heavy metals that your body is actively trying to get out of the system. The best indicator for an active antigen is the cause of the of your child's abnormal dominance is the helper suppressor ratio on the T and B cell panel. This is also called the CD4-CD8 ratio. The closer to 2.5 or above, the more likely it is that your child is trying to remove an active antigen. If that ratio falls below 1.2, then your child's most likely dealing with an immune dysregulation problem, and we treat these differently. Now, we also run what is called an intestinal permeability test. This test allows us to determine if your child suffers from leaky gut syndrome. Okay, leaky gut syndrome is a condition where the walls of the intestines have been damaged and become infected. Now, this is oftentimes caused because of antibiotic exposure, toxins to the diet, poor diet, eating foods that you're allergic to, parasite infections. But this leads to increased permeability of the gut wall to toxins, to microbes, to undigested food, and to larger than normal macromolecules that you consume in your food. Once these substances get through the gut wall, they can affect the body directly, or they can cause an immune reaction which actually promotes inflammation in your child's brain and body. Not a good thing. Now, how do I successfully address your child's positive metabolic findings? Well, what I do is I use specific nutritional protocols and lifestyle changes based on the results of your child's lab results. It's very specific. We also utilize glutathione, which is a very powerful antioxidant to help decrease inflammation in your child's brain and body. Now, after we've addressed the metabolic side, we're going to address the neurologic side. And remember, we want to bring balance back to the brain. So we use brain-based therapies. Some of these, as examples, are oxygen therapy. We may use cerebellum rehabilitation, where we have your child stand on the left leg and catch a ball on the right to stimulate the right brain. We use vestibular stimulation. This involves spins and head position to stimulate various inner ear canals on the left side, and then that signals over to the right side of the brain. We use hemi-stim visual stimulation programs, such as eye light therapy, which flashes lights in your child's eyes and drives brain function. We use auditory low-frequency stimulation. We use olfactory stimulations, which is using your sense of smell. For instance, unpleasant smells in the right nostril stimulate and fire off the right brain. We use postural exercises, okay, to strengthen those gross motor centers. We use cross-crawl patterns, neck raises, chest raises. We're also going to perform balance exercises. Okay, we use a program and a therapy called the interactive metronome, which is a state-of-the-art, very well-researched program that's very helpful in the treatment of kids with dyslexia. Our office sessions typically are going to be 2 to 3 times a week for 90 days, and so it's very, very repetitive. We're doing this stuff day in and day out, and it's very important to develop plastic changes in your child's brain. You as a parent must be willing to work with your children at home and to enforce our protocols if they're going to be successful. My program has extremely successful rates, and it's partially due to my unique approach, but also to my screening process. I'm not going to accept children that I don't believe that I can help. So after we go through an assessment with your child, I'll be able to inform you of whether or not his problem is something that we can help in our office. If not, I'm going to refer you to the appropriate specialist with your test results. Now, the good thing to know is that your child's brain function will improve, okay, given the proper therapy. Now, it's important to understand that the unique thing about my practice and my treatment is that we're going to address both the metabolic and the neurologic side and rebalance that brain. Now, in closing, I want you to consider the following 4 factors regarding your child's health and really well-being. I want you to picture yourself congratulating your son or daughter on a straight A report card. Finally, a report card that you can brag about, right? It's tougher and tougher for kids to even get into a good college, and so grades are more important than ever now. I know as a working adult that it's hard to work competitively, to be in the business world, and to have time for your family and your spouse, and still have time for doing something like this for your son or your daughter. I know, I'm a parent of 2, But even with that said, it's so important that you take the time to do whatever it takes to give your kids the best quality of life possible. What's going to happen to your kids when you're gone? Okay? We all know that better grades lead to college scholarships, and I want you to imagine the joy that your child will feel receiving a scholarship, as well as the light and load that would be put on your pocketbook, right? That's a concern of mine. And finally, if you really care and love your child, and I know you do, remember, you will have to crawl through glass to help them have the best life they can live. I never said my program is easy. There is no easy fix for this, but I can assure you that the sacrifices that you'll make for your child are worth it. Now, in closing, I would like to ask you this. Please share this information with family members, friends, that you feel it may help. There's a lot of children out there that are suffering these same conditions. And so please, if you know somebody, share with them. It can change their life as well. Now, I know that you've taken the time to watch this video, and therefore I know that you care deeply about someone that's being held back by dyslexia. Please, make sure to call my office at 763-398-7770 now to get your child scheduled for a consultation with me. We'll take the time to review your child's case history in detail, discover if your child qualifies for our program. I'm looking for patients that are warriors, patients that are willing to crawl through glass and do whatever it takes to get their child better. Thank you so much for your time today. And again, call my office, 763-398-7770. Get your child scheduled to come in. We'll sit down and review the case and find out if we can get your kid started on getting better. Thank you so much for your time. Have a great day.